right, so in performance, what we talk about a lot is how to get from point A to point B in the most efficient manner possible. So what we're going to talk about right now is just basic ways of getting over obstacles in a very simple manner and just having control and stability through full range of motion. That's something we talk about all the time. And being able to do that without wasting time and maybe taking advantage of other situations that are happening around you. So we're going to start talking about the step vault, which is a very easy way of getting over a piece of equipment, like it may be in our case in the parking lot, we just have this yoke hanging around. So what we're going to do is we're just going to be walking and ideally be able to get over that piece of equipment without much effort and without having to look down or look away and always having control over that movement. So once again, when I'm saying control, I'm talking about being able to step over, find balance, step through, and keep moving. In the case of Rickard, that's our special guest today. If he's out in the field and he's carrying a lot of equipment, he's carrying a gun, he has a big vest on, you have the plates on, boots, pants, all kinds of stuff.
Yeah.
And sometimes you have to get over stuff, and the last thing you want to do is see yourself rolling and falling and doing all kinds of weird things and wasting time and energy. So we're just going to address a basic way of getting over an obstacle and how to make it as efficient as possible. Okay, so let's take it over here. Let's see what we can do. So the first thing you're going to do, Rickard, is just going to place whatever hand you prefer on the bar. Usually it's the opposite hand of where your weapon would be carried. So if you're carrying your weapon with your right hand, left hand is going to be your support.
Yeah.
All I want you to do is walk up to the obstacle, place your hand down. Doesn't matter if the palm is facing forward or back. I ideally would recommend palm facing forward. Just that open hand position, more anatomical position, more stable position. So just walk up, place your hand. Good. Easy stuff to do, right?
Yeah.
Step one. Step two, come on back. I want you to step up. You're gonna place your hand, place your foot. And ideally, this foot will be planted maybe mid-foot or a little bit back on the balls of your feet just because you have a little bit better support, and feel like your left arm is your post. Give that a shot. Good. Easy. Feels comfortable, right?
Yeah, it does.
Now come on out of it. Next step we want to do is we want to be able to come in, place our hand foot, see if you can put some pressure, lift the bottom leg. Hand foot, lift the bottom leg. Good. He's supposed to be able to balance there, no problem. He has equal weight on his legs and his arms right now. Now what we want to see is we want to see if you can thread and sit down. So you're going to place hand foot, stand, thread, sit. If that feels comfortable. Hand, foot, thread, and hopefully you want to sit.
Yeah.
I know you're going to be moving, but this is just a way of starting to work on control and traction throughout full range of motion. If he doesn't have control over his movement throughout the full range, something's wrong, there's some deficiencies there. So this is just a way of exaggerating that greatness that we were talking about earlier. So hand down, foot down, press, thread the leg, sit down. Sit down on the bar.
Okay.
Good. You can sit down on it.
Okay.
There you go.
Yeah.
Does that make sense? And now you can step up.
Yeah.
So what you want to feel is you want to feel like you're supported, that you can balance, that you can pull your leg up, thread, sit down fully, and now just step off calmly. Make sense?
Yes.
See if you can do that one more time. Hand, foot, thread, sit down, and step. Good. So if he has that, now we want to move on to the next step, which is hand down, foot up, thread, miss the seat, open the hip. The hip extends, and now I can just walk out of it. See if you can do that. Very simple movements, but trying to put some efficiency into it. Pushes, hip extends, foot comes down, he can keep walking. As simple as that. How does that feel?
Feels really good.
Feels,
it looks like a really basic movement, but definitely need some training on it.
Yeah, so basic movement, but definitely need some training, meaning that you have to practice it.
Yeah.
Now if we do it with speed, the goal is to be able to come through. Let's say I'm walking a little faster, come through, push, and keep walking through. Notice that I did not drop my head at any time. I'm always looking straight ahead, eye on the game, right?
Yeah.
So give that a shot, see how that feels. Good, thread through. And this is when we start talking about kind of that sixth sense, proprioception, being able to feel what's around your body without having to directly look at it, and just having your focus on the main picture, the big picture.
Yeah.
So try that one more time, but don't look down, try to just feel your way through it. Trust that you have the movement down and that you can get over that obstacle. So you're looking straight ahead, hand goes down, goes through, and keeps walking. Good job. Now, let's say you're running, you're coming out of some kind of situation where you're running into, you're having to look straight ahead, and you're just moving your way through. See how that feels. Good, so that starts getting a little bit awkward because we start adding speed, no big deal. See if you can do it again. Don't look at the obstacle, look straight ahead. The obstacle is not there. You're just looking where your end goal is, which is straight ahead. Straight ahead, up, press, press through. Nice range of motion. What we're trying to look for is that his center of mass travels in a straight line. So as he's coming over, there's not a big shift. And he's really using kind of this frontal plane to go laterally one way or another. This is something I learned from Brian Orosco, free runner. So if you're watching, thank you so much. I hope I didn't butcher it too much, but I really saw that it could be a good application into what we see in the military or other law enforcement and firefighters just to get through obstacles. How did that feel? Okay?
Yeah, it feels good.
Good. Does this make sense to you? Do you think this is something that you should be practicing at least as like a warm-up piece or just getting aware of what the body positions look like while doing so?
Absolutely. It looks really easy, like an easy move, but working on it like just a couple of minutes now, I've made it much easier. You know, I can concentrate on my surroundings instead of the obstacle.
That's right. Yeah. That's right. And then you want to also try it with weight vest, all your equipment, all your gear, see if you can perform the same movement. The center of mass changes. Once again, we have to try all the different modalities and specialties to be able to transfer nicely into whatever your skill is. So this is, once again, just a tool to make you better at what you do outside. You can interpret it however you want. It's your thing. Thank you. Good job, man.